Liverpool versus Chelsea is a fixture which is very special for us and for the gentleman joining us as well, Aru. He is one of the founders of Chelsea Mumbai. He's a special and a very, very dear friend. I remember our first screening, my personally first screening was in 2007 at Irish pub, and Aru and his gang were there. And only three, four Liverpool supporters turned up, and Liverpool won that game. But the rivalry has been amazing since we've started to follow football. Rafa versus Jose Mourinho. We had the two semi-finals, the ghost goal of Luis Garcia, the Didier Drogba celebration in front of Rafa Benitez, then the Gerrard slip, the Mo Salah goal. It goes on and on and on. Aru, we've known each other since almost 16, 17 years now. How has the rivalry evolved for you, Liverpool versus Chelsea?
I think for me, I think the rivalry has also evolved in the sense where I have aged a lot. Like you rightfully said, right? We've known each other 16, 17 years. And as you grow, you kind of start taking it in a different sense. Well, not everyone, but at least some of us do. When it started, I remember as in Roman Abramovich could have bought Liverpool, right? It was the game, Chelsea Liverpool game, where Chelsea won, qualified for Europe, and then Roman, everything, as they say, everything else is history. So I was in my teens when I founded Chelsea India Club, football supporters club. So for that rivalry at that point was very intense. Plus the managers both of us had were also very intense. I think our managers have also mellowed down. Mellowed down, obviously they have a lot of passion, but they are in a sense not at each other's throats. Like you see Klopp talking about Tuchel in a very nice way. Tuchel talking about Klopp in a very nice way. And for me and you as well, I don't think even in the first screening that you attended, even though there were fights, we were always the ones separating everyone else away, right? But I think if we had a joint screening today, unfortunately we don't under these COVID times, but if we did, I think it would be a lot more mature screening. Obviously, there would be banter and fun and all that. But I think we have come to a place where both clubs, and fans of both clubs respect each other. Where Chelsea is no longer nobody who spend money, and Liverpool is not some team who hasn't won for a long time, right? I think in some form we've reached a parity where both of our clubs respect each other, both the fans of both the clubs respect each other. And that I think is how this has evolved.
Absolutely. And I think football in general has mellowed down quite a lot compared to when, the times that you mentioned. But talking about this game, Aru, what are your expectations from both Liverpool and Chelsea going into this fixture?
Expectations, I would want Chelsea to win, obviously. But being a bit realistic, I think if you notice the Arsenal game as well, there is still a lot of, what do you say, the front three haven't really clicked. There were chances, there were times where, Mount could have played Lukaku in, and Lukaku was pointing like this, and Kai Havertz pointing like this. And that happened a lot. Reece had a cutback when Lukaku had just scored the goal when he went past the first defender, crossed past the first defender when he went long. So I think these things worked out with Arsenal because their defense is not the best. But I feel with Liverpool, they are a different beast altogether, right? With Virgil van Dijk back and the defense clicking, it's not going to be so easy. So I do feel this, and especially at being at Anfield, I really. I don't fancy our chances, but I still think this will be a very close fought game. I don't think there will be much in it. It'll be a goal that separates the two teams.
Yeah, Manas, that was going to be my next question. Now, last time Chelsea played at Anfield, they won. Mason Mount goal, right? This time, it is slightly different because the fans are back. Manas, do you think that is going to be, something that is going to deter Chelsea? Because Chelsea have shown to be mentally very strong.
Of course, I mean, it's going to be totally different. It's going to be, I mean, the fans being back for us, Nidhi, I mean, we know what our club is all about. It's the emotion. It's it. I mean, Klopp basically passes it on to the crowd, the crowd passes it on to the players, and the opposite players as well at times get rattled. I don't think it will happen to Chelsea, because yeah. Chelsea is a huge, I mean, they're champions of Europe, man. I mean, you have to give them respect. But then again, totally different game, totally different atmosphere. First big game after 18 months at Anfield, where the crowd is going to be there. And I personally feel that we are up against the favorite to win the title. Because Manchester City have not signed their player. They needed a striker. They haven't. When we are shooting this right now, there are rumors that Chelsea might sign another centre-back. They might sign Saul as well. I mean, if that freaking happens, I mean, Chelsea's squad is going to be insane. But with Anfield, I think 55 or 60-40 in favour of Liverpool, only because of Anfield. And Robbo is going to be back, which is going to be a huge boost. But the battle, Arubhai, the battle has to be Lukaku versus Van Dijk, right?
Yeah, for sure. as in, it's the kind of battle that you like to see, you know. It's like no one puts it better than the Dark Knight, you know, an immovable object and an unstoppable force going against each other. It's literally like that. And it's going to be something that's going to be a treat for everyone. Whoever comes on top, again, it will not be something like a huge difference. It'll be, yeah. You know, like you said, 55-45 or 60-40 between the two. And I do hope it will be Lukaku who comes out on top. But with Anfield, like you rightfully said, you know, like the crowd itself gives a huge advantage to Liverpool. Even if, like, you know, you remember nights in under Rafa Benitez when your squad wasn't the best. Any team coming to Anfield is always the second favorite. No, doesn't matter who's on the other team.
Yeah.
Nidhi, I'm going to interrupt you and ask you about Lukaku. Lukaku's second coming at Chelsea. He's played at Man United. He's won the league at Inter.
Yeah.
We have spoken about the fact that he looks so much fitter now. He looks like a different beast. How do you, not that I'm accusing him of not being fit back in the past, but he just looks a different beast right now. Nidhi, this is probably going to be a one-on-one for Virgil van Dijk, the toughest test in the league.
I think it would be. Look, I was talking to someone and, you know, we had this interesting observation that Mo Salah, when he left Chelsea and, you know, went to Italy and played and came back, he had a point to prove because the Premier League had not been very kind to Mo Salah. That is the same situation with Lukaku. Lukaku, of course, played for, you know, Chelsea, then West Brom, then, you know, Everton, then United, and, you know, things happened. He was not a very big success in the Premier League. This is it. And now he's coming back as a champion. So I am very excited, but I'll tell you one player that, you know, we are not talking about when talking about key battles with Lukaku, and that's Fabinho. I think the way Chelsea will be set up, there will be a lot of attacks through the middle, and Fabinho will be very, very important, as much as Van Dijk, I would say.
Yeah. I mean, we have to be on top of our game to get a result here. Nidhi mentioned about Mo Salah. Arup, I mean, Jose Mourinho bought Mo Salah, okay? And I still remember Mo Salah started the game where Gerrard slipped and we had a joint screening. He started for Chelsea. A lot has happened. We won the Champions League. He has helped us win the league. How does it feel from a Chelsea fan's point of view to see a player who's played for you not for long excel so much and become one of the best in the world with Liverpool?
Personally, I'm just happy for him, right? Like, I don't wish ill for anyone, right?
Yeah.
And end of the day, if you have a player who's come and played for you, right? And if it didn't work out, things don't work out. Yeah? Things don't work out between two people, two friends, two couples or whatever. We don't have to have judges against that person. That person has gone on, proved themselves, come back and done well. right? Had we signed Salah back again, people might be like, why did you do that or whatever, right? And it was meant to be, right? In some ways, had Salah not, like you rightfully said, if he didn't have that point to prove, maybe he wouldn't have turned into the player that he is today. And that comes from the fact that if he I wouldn't say failed, but he wasn't a whole lot of success at Chelsea. Yeah. And then went to Serie A, was a success there. And even, I think Serie A fans would be surprised by the kind of success he's had at Liverpool. I don't think even they kind of saw what has happened. Else you would have seen a Salah transfer fee being much, much higher than what you guys actually paid. So for me, there's no, I'm just happy for him.
Right. So, you know, a couple more questions and we'll wrap this up. Aru, what is the starting lineup that you personally would be going with?
Does Werner start? Does Werner start this?
I don't see Werner starting.
Why not,
yaar? Honestly, I do feel he's a lot underrated. His finishing is obviously, he's been panned for a lot, and that remains a problem. But I think even if you look at the Champions League final, it is Werner who kind of creates that space for everyone else. His runs, his pace. Even for Arsenal, if you see how Lukaku was dragging people away every single time, that's the kind of role Werner did very well. I don't see him starting though. It will be Mount, Lukaku, Kai Havertz, Alonso, Jorginho, Kante, Rhys James, Rudiger, Christensen, Aspie, Mendy.
Aspi plays back three, man.
Yeah.
Aspi plays in a back three, right, Aru?
Yeah. Aspi plays right centre back in back three.
Yeah, and Reece James plays right wing back. Nidhi, that is going to be a very interesting one, right?
Yeah, that is
going to be right wing back.
Look, you know, honestly, Manas, I cannot. You know, this will be, like Arup mentioned, it will not be easy for either teams. Yes, we are at Anfield. Yes, the crowd is back. But make no mistake, this is not going to be a cakewalk for us. It is, Chelsea are going to test us. We are going to test Chelsea. It'll be amazing.
I don't think there is even one Liverpool fan who thinks it will be a cakewalk by any stretch of the imagination, bro. Like, it's going to be tough, bro.
Except for the social media, you know, people, I don't think anybody thinks this is an easy game for any other side. Manas, what is the lineup that you will be going with for Liverpool?
Okay, so Robbo is back.
Yeah.
Van Dijk and Matip.
Mm-hmm.
Trent. Ali and goal, of course.
Yeah.
This is where it gets interesting, right? Because Fabinho, I think, has to start.
Yeah.
Henderson has to start. Naby Keita has played well because he would want solidity. I personally will go for Thiago. So my personal lineup will be Henderson, Fabinho, Thiago, Salah, Mane, Jota.
Okay.
For you, Nidhi, any changes for you?
I would just start Firmino instead of Jota. And I'll tell you why. You know, Firmino gives us that extra bit of elasticity against the Chelsea defense. And also, if at any point we are chasing the game, we can bring on Jota from the bench. And he'll give us that spring of, you know, energy. So with that, we'll close the video. Manas, your predictions for the game?
My prediction for the game is that I know I'm going to be drunk while I watch it. That's the only prediction I'm going to give. I'm too nervous to give a prediction. I hope we win. It's going to be 1-0 for either side. Arup, your prediction?
I'll sit on the fence. I think it's going to be a 1-1.
That is indeed possible. I'm very superstitious that way. I don't do predictions. But Aru, thank you, man. Thank you for making the time to do this for us. Really gracious of you. By the way, this is Menace and the Monk. And this was our Chelsea preview. Can't wait for the game. And we'll be coming up with much more content. Cheers and bye-bye.
You guys. Bye-bye.